Greetings, Kiss Nation. And recently this channel has hit 400 subscribers, and for that I gotta say, thank you. It means a lot that I'm worth your time and attention, and I know I say that a lot in all of these milestone videos, but genuinely and sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, I mean it. And I'm gonna keep saying thank you to you guys every time this channel hits a milestone, whether it's a big milestone or a small milestone. Doesn't matter what milestone this channel has hit, I'm going to keep saying thank you to you guys, because without you guys, it wouldn't be as much fun doing this stuff, and because you guys make it all worthwhile, and to that, that's why I'm saying thank you. Anyways, what I'm going to do for this milestone video is I'm going to be reviewing most of the non-makeup 80s Kiss albums, because the 80s non-makeup Kiss albums is where I got into Kiss. My first two Kiss albums were Alive 2 and Alive 3, but I'm saving the reviewing the live albums for a bigger milestone video, and I figured I can at least talk about my getting into Kiss phase for this video. So the albums we're going to be talking about is Animalize, Asylum, Crazy Nights, and Smash, Destroys, and Hits. So for starters, let's get into Animalize. Animalize came out in 1984. It was the first and only Kiss album to feature Mark St. John, although Mark St. John played a little bit on the Animalize tour, but he wasn't, you know, permanently on the tour. Bruce did most of the shows on the tour because Mark St. John had, you know, some sort of arthritic condition with his hand, which kind of, you know, made it so he couldn't do most of the shows. But there are some audience recordings with him, which there's a show in Baltimore and there's a show in New York. Now, Animalize is probably one of my favorite non-makeup Kiss albums. I got Animalize as a birthday gift, and I really enjoy listening to this album. I've listened to it recently, and it's really good, and, well, let's get this review started.
We'll be right back. Here are my final thoughts on Animalize. Like I said, the songs on this album are really good, they're really kick-ass, and let's talk about the songs. For starters, we got I've Had Enough, Into the Fire. This is a really great opener, and I really love this song. Next, we got Heaven's on Fire. Heaven's on Fire is an awesome song. It stayed with them throughout the 80s and throughout the rest of the non-makeup era in the live shows, and they still play the song currently to this day, which shows you how popular the song was and still is. Next is Burn Bitch Burn. This song, when I was a teenager, I always skipped it. I never really got into the song. Now the song to me is it's listenable at best. But I'm not gonna listen to it on repeat sometimes or at all because I'm still meh on it. Get All You Can Take. I really like this song. I really love the song. It's an awesome song. It's really cool. Lonely is the Hunt. This is a better Gene song than Burn Bitch Burn, in my opinion. I thought that way as a teenager and I still think that way now. Just for some reason, Burn Bitch Burn is the only song off this whole album that just doesn't really mesh well with me. Under the Gun. This is a really cool song. I think Bruce and his cruise band played it, on the cruise. Because that band plays a lot of the 80s songs, which I find really cool. Plays a lot of the 80s and non-makeup stuff. And Kiss has played this song another time in the non-makeup phase, on the Hot Maché tour. Played it at one of their Detroit shows, which is pretty cool. Next we got Thrills in the Night. This is my favorite song off the whole album. I love this song, and I actually really love that solo. It's really fucking cool. Now, Kiss also has played this song on the Animalize tour, also at Detroit. So that's pretty cool. Next we got While the City Sleeps. This is another good Gene song. I always really liked this song. Thought it was really good. Next we got Murder Not Healed, but the album closer. This is another good Gene song. It's really cool to listen to, and I've always liked it. Alright. There you have it. That was Animalize. I'll get into the final verdicts later. Next, we're going into Asylum.
Asylum, the new Kiss album. Accept no imitations. Mercury Records and Tapes, Kiss Asylum. You'll be crazy about it.
Available at all Tape World and Record Town locations for $6.99.
Now, Asylum, I got as a Christmas gift the same year I got Animalize. And I think Asylum is a really awesome follow-up to Animalize. The only downside I have with Asylum is the damn look that they had for their tour. It's 80s in the worst way, and luckily they ditched that look after the tour was over, because I did not. Once I saw that look they had for the tour, I was like, God, man, that's awful. But anyways, the songs on Asylum are really good, and let's get this review started.
I'm gonna play. couldn't you do?
Here are my final thoughts on Asylum. Like I said, the songs on Asylum are really good. They're about the same level of kick-ass that Amylize had, if not more. So let's talk about the songs. First, we got King of the Mountain. Fucking killer opener. Love that drum intro that Eric Carr did in the studio. It was so cool to hear. Then you actually get into the song. It's really kick-ass. I love this song. It's so cool. Then we get Any Way You Slice. This is really cool. I love the song. It's awesome. Next we got Who Wants to Be Lonely. I love this song. I saw the music video of this on Kiss Exposed way back when this used to be on YouTube, back in like 2008 and 2009, and I thought the music video was pretty good. That was like when I first saw that look that Kiss had for the Asylum days, and I was like, it's interesting, and it also kind of gave me that glimpse of what Kiss was without the makeup. It was like, at that time, I only
knowledge of Kiss was that Sydney 1980 video. And anyways, Who Wants to Be Lonely is a really awesome song. I love it. Next we got Trial by Fire. One of my favorite non-makeup Gene songs. I love this song. This is really cool. I listened to it non-stop as a teenager, and to this day I still do. It's really cool. Next we got I'm Alive. This is really cool. I like this song. I like it. It's really good. It's just a song by Paul Stanley. Next we got Love's a Deadly Weapon. There was a demo of this song that was sung by Paul, which was kind of interesting, but in the final version of the song, it ends up being a Gene song. So, both versions I find, the demo sung by Paul and the actual song sung by Gene, both are pretty good. So this is a really good song too. Next we got Tears Are Falling. As a teenager, when I saw the music video, I thought, what the hell am I watching? Because the first thing I saw was a girl just basically crying, like, what the hell is this? So that's what I first thought. Then I see Kiss and they're get up, and I'm like, okay, strange outfits, but alright. And the song is not that bad. It's a pretty good song. As a teenager, I gave the song a lot of shit because I thought the video was garbage. But looking at it now, the music video is not that bad. And the song is pretty good. Next we got Secretly Cool. This is another really good Gene song. I really love this song. Also love the guitar solo. That is really good also. Next we got Radar for Love. This is also a really good song. I love it. Next is All Night. Now this song got played on the Asylum tour. I think Who Wants to Be Lonely got played on the Asylum tour also, although I could be wrong, but I know both Who Wants to Be Lonely and All Night got played on this year's cruise, which I think is really cool. And I know All Night got played at the Charlotte, North Carolina show. It was really cool that Kiss brought out two Asylum songs for this year's cruise. Excuse me. So there you have it. That was Asylum. And now let's go to Crazy Nights. Now Crazy Nights, I got this album when I was about 15, 16. And this album is an okay album. I mean, it has a few songs that I went back and forth on when I was in my late teens, early 20s. But now it's kind of like, do I like those songs or do I hate those songs? Well, now, let's get this review started.
Try to tell us we don't belong. That's all right.
Here are my final thoughts on Crazy Nights. Like I said, this album has some okay songs, and there are some songs I'm kinda meh on. So, let's get into the songs. For starters, we got Crazy Nights. This is a really good opener to the album, and the thing about this one is there'll be two more copycat songs and be as the album goes on. But only two more. Next we got I'll Fight Hell to Hold You. Well, this is a really good song, and I know for listening to the album. Not the album, but the song. Sorry about that. Next we got Bang Bang You. This is one of the songs I kind of went back and forth on as a teenager. I either liked it or I hated it when I went back and forth in my late teenage early 20s. Now, I'm kind of iffy on it. I do think the song is listenable. It's an okay song. I'm not going to say it's a great song, but I do think the song is okay and it's listenable. Now, they did add. Now, this song was played on the Crazy Nights tour, and I did think the song was good live. I thought it worked in live in the show. Next, we got No, No, No. This song I like a lot better than Bang Bang You. And I did think this song actually was a really good live song. And I thought when Bruce did his guitar solo, it worked better live. It was really cool to hear live. Next, Hell or High Water. This, for a short period of time, was actually played live on the Crazy Nights tour. And it was really cool to hear because out of all the Crazy Nights shows I have, getting one with Hell or High Water, that was really cool. And it was really cool to hear it live, and I do wish they would have kept it because this one is a really good song. Next we got My Way. My Way is an okay song. I'm not that big on the song, but I do find it listenable. Next we got When Your Walls Come Down. This was another song that was, for a brief period of time, was played live. The only show that I do have it on, where both Hell or High Water and When Your Walls Come Down, was the Pensacola show. That's the only show I have where those two songs were both played live. And it's really cool to hear. And then When Your Walls Come Down, it's also a good song. I like it. Next up is Reason to Live. In the later years of the Crazy Nights tour, both Bang Bang You and No Reason to Live remain staples to the tour, where I guess Hell or High Water and When Your Walls Come Down were just scrapped. But Reason to Live is a good song. It's kind of cool to, if you got a chance to see it live, you would see Bruce Kulick play a keyboard. That was kind of cool. Next is Good Girl Gone Bad. I've always enjoyed this song. It was a really good Gene song, in my opinion. And I still think it is to this day. Next is Turn on the Night. This is a really good song. I've always enjoyed this song. It's so fun to hear, and I love hearing it. It's so cool. Next is Thief in the Night, a really good closer to this album. I've always enjoyed it. I love Gene on this song, and it's really fucking cool. Alright, so there you have it. That was Crazy Nights. Once again, we'll do a final verse later. And on to the very last album of this whole review, and that is Smashes, Thrashes, and Hits.
Collection isn't complete without Smashes, Thrashes, and Hits. 13 rockers, remixed and remastered, plus two new tracks produced by Paul Stanley. Don't miss Smashes, Thrashes, and Hits.
Now, Smashes, Thrashes, and Hits was the first Kiss album that I got with my own money. Yeah, it was a best of, but at the time, I didn't care. It was the first Kiss album that I bought with my own money. And I would listen to that album constantly. And it introduced me to a lot of the Kiss songs, whether it be from the 70s or whether it be from the 80s. It was mostly songs from the 80s. Like early 80s, mid to late 80s, like a lot of stuff. And it had, you know, like two new songs, and it had a lot of remixes from classic Kiss songs from the 70s. So let's get this review started. My final thoughts on Smashes, Thrashes, and Hits. Like I said, it was the first Kiss album that I'd bought with my own money, even though it was the best of, I didn't really care. And it had two new songs, which were produced by Paul Stanley, and it had remixes of the classic 70s Kiss songs, and it introduced me to a lot of the 80s Kiss songs, like early 80s, mid to late 80s. Like Heaven's on Fire, Tears Are Falling, Lick It Up. Now, those songs weren't remixed. They were kind of like the album cut versions. But I will tell you what songs were remixed and what weren't. But first, let's talk about the two new songs. Let's Put the X in Sex. This is a really cool song. I enjoy it. The only time that it was played live was during their convention shows, which was kind of interesting. We hear them put the X in Sex in an acoustic setting. It was kind of cool. It was cool and it worked. I liked it. Next was You Make Me Rock Hard. Now, the only time this was ever played live was with Bruce Kulick and his solo band. And Bruce wasn't the one singing it. It was Sebastian Gaba, the star child of the Argentinian band Kiss My Ass. And Sebastian Gabba has the voice for it because he's a really good star child. He's up there with Rich Kosak from Mr. Speed. Now, You Make Me Rock Hard is another great song. I enjoy that. Excuse me. Now, for the songs that are remixed, Love Gun is remixed. I actually really enjoy hearing this version because once Paul screams Love Gun, you can hear nothing but the solo, which is really good. I enjoy that. Next is Dirt Rock City, which I'm kind of trying to figure out if this is different or not. It doesn't really sound a lot different, but it's still pretty cool. Next, I Love It Loud, which is a terrible remix. They took Eric Carr's powerful drum sounds from Creeps of the Night and made it sound like he's hitting tin cans. It's awful. It's really awful. Next is Deuce. I know this sounds a little bit different. Lick It Up is the album version. Heaven's on Fire is the album version. Calling Dr. Love is different. And this was the main reason that I wanted to get this album, because at the time, this was the only song I gave a crap about. I wanted to hear nothing other than this song. Next is Strutter. Strutter sounds a little bit different, but it's still a pretty good version. Next is Beth of Eric Carr. This was the version that introduced me to Beth. Not the version from Alive 2, but the version from Smashes. And I thought Eric Carr did a good job singing it. And once I heard Eric Carr singing it, I immediately went to Alive 2 and heard Peterson singing, and I thought, damn, this is really good. Next we got Tears Are Falling, which is the album version. I Was Made For Loving You, which is the album version. Rocker All Night, which has been mixed differently. And Shout It Out Loud, which has been mixed differently. So there you have it. Now, let's get into final verdicts. Analyze. This is a really awesome 80s album, and it has a lot of great songs, so I would give it a 10 out of 10. This has a lot of kick-ass songs, with the exception of one, but I never really got into Burn Bitch Burn, but the rest of the songs are fucking killer songs. That's why I get 10 out of 10. Next, we got Asylum. Asylum is a nice follow-up to Analyze, and it has a lot of kick-ass songs to boot. So next, for the final verdict, I would give Asylum another 10 out of 10. Great kick-ass songs, love them all around, and yeah, 10 out of 10. Next, Crazy Nights. Crazy Nights has some songs that I like into some songs I'm like, meh on. So I would give it a 8.5 out of 10. This is an okay album to listen to. It's got some really good songs on it, and some songs that I'm just iffy on. So yeah, 8.5 out of 10. Next we got Smash, Thrust, and Hits. The things I'm gonna count this one on is like the two new songs, which are really good, the remixes, which some are good, which is Love Gun, Dr. Love, and Deuce, Rock One Night, and Shout Out Loud. The one that is really shitty is I Love It Loud, and well, I'm going to give Smashes a little bit higher ranking than the normal best of ranking, which is a 7 out of 10. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. This is a best of, but it has new things to offer. It's got two new songs that you can only get on this best of, and it's got a few new remixed versions of songs. And yeah, there are some songs that are just, you know, the same album versions of that you can hear on the album, but I think the remixed versions and the two new songs kind of are worth getting it the 8 out of 10. So yeah. So this has been the 400th subscriber special and this deep dive review of most of the 80s non-naked Kiss album. And before I sign off, I just want to say again, thank you for your support of the channel. Really means a lot, and like I said in the beginning, without you guys, it wouldn't be as much fun as it is doing it, because you make it all worthwhile. And I didn't suspect this channel to get this far, and this has kind of been really surprising to see. Even though the channel has made it to 400, well, like I said in the beginning, no matter how big the milestone is, no matter how small the milestone is, I'm going to keep thanking you, because you guys make it worth it. So thank you. So like I said, this has been the form of the special and the review, and this deep dive review of non-Naked Baby's Kiss albums. Hope you liked it. Next time we meet, we'll be back for our regular scheduled program of Kiss This, a main man's tribute to Kiss.